Welcome, my dear students. In this video, we will discuss about some elementary property regarding the algebraic structure of real numbers. The properties are, if Z and A are real numbers, with Z plus A is equal to A, whenever for any A, then Z should be equal to 0. That is, the only element which gives the answer itself under addition operation with any element should be 0. Similar operation can be done in the case of multiplication as well. If U and B are elements with B not equal to 0, with U dot B is equal to B, then U should be equal to 1. That is, the only element which gives the answer itself under multiplication operation should be 1. Okay. So whenever we take any element and operating under multiplication with some other element, if the answer is the element itself, then the second element should be 1. Third property is, if A is a real number, then A dot 0 should always be 0. First, in this case, we have to prove that Z plus A is equal to A implies Z is equal to 0. So we write Z as Z plus 0 using the additive identity property of real numbers. Then 0 can be written as A plus minus A under additive inverse property. So Z plus A plus minus A. Then using associative property of addition, this can be written as Z plus A plus minus A. We have already assumed that Z plus A is equal to A. So this can be written as A plus minus A. A plus minus A is always 0. We have started with Z, so the answer should be Z equal to 0. So we have proved that Z plus A is equal to A implies Z is equal to 0. Now moving on to the second case, similar to the first case, instead of Z, we write U, instead of A, we write B. And instead of addition, we use multiplication. So U can be written as U dot 1 under multiplicative identity property. Then 1 can be written as B into 1 by B. Since B is not equal to 0, then 1 by B exists in the case of multiplicative inverse. Then by associative property, this can be written as U dot B into 1 by B. U dot B can be written as B by our assumption. So this is equal to B into 1 by B, which is equal to 1. So we have started from U, that is U should be equal to 1 whenever U dot B is equal to B. Moving on to the third property, we have to prove that A dot 0 should be equal to 0. We start with A plus A into 0, A dot 0. This can be written as A dot 1 plus A dot 0 by using the additive identity property. Then by distributive property, we take A as common. So this can be written as A into 1 plus 0. We know that 1 plus 0 is 1. So the answer should be A into 1, which is equal to A. So what we get is A plus A into 0 should be equal to A. Then if we add minus A, that is the additive inverse of A on both sides, the left hand side becomes A into 0, the right hand side becomes 0. So A into 0 should be equal to 0. So this is the proof of the three elementary properties in the case of set of all real numbers. And in other properties, we have similar other properties in the case of real numbers, which is stated as a theorem. The theorem states that if A not equal to 0 and B belongs to R are such that A dot B equal to 1, then B should be equal to 1 by U, which states that if the product of two real numbers is additive identity, then one should be the additive inverse of the other. If the product of two real numbers gives the identity, multiplicative identity, one should be the multiplicative inverse of the other. Or in the set of all real numbers, if operating two elements gives the multiplicative identity, then one element should be the multiplicative inverse of the other. And the second property is, if product of two numbers is zero, then either A should be zero or B should be zero. Or the product of two numbers is zero implies at least one of them should be equal to zero. So we move on to the first. Here we have to prove that B is equal to 1 by A. We start with that. So B can be written as B into 1 by multiplicative identity property. So 1 can be written as A into 1 by A. So this can be written as B into A into 1 by A. So by associative property, this can be written as B into A into 1 by A. We have already assumed that A into B is equal to 1 by set of all real numbers. In the case of real numbers, A dot B should be equal to B dot A. So B dot A should be equal to A dot B, which is 1. So this can be written as 1 into 1 by A. 1 into 1 by A is always 1 by A. So we have successfully proved that B is equal to 1 by A. Next, we will prove that A dot B is equal to 0, then A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0. In this case, we first assume that A is not equal to 0. Then we have to prove that B is equal to 0 or vice versa. If we assume that B not equal to 0, we will prove that A is equal to 0. We start with 1 by A into AB, which can be written as 1 by A into A, 1 by A into A into B by associative property. Since 1 by A into A is 1, so which can be written as 1 into B. 1 into B is always 1 by multiplicative identity property. So 1 by A into AB can be B. Similarly, if we operate again, 1 by A into AB should be equal to 1 by A into 0. We have already proved that A into 0 is always 0. That is, 1 by A into 0 should always be 0. Here, 1 by A into AB is B. 1 by A into AB is 0 as well. Equating them on both sides, we will get the answer as B is equal to 0. So, if the product of two numbers is 0 and A is not equal to 0, then B should be equal to 0, which in turn means that the product of two numbers is 0 implies at least one of them should be 0.